In a few short minutes, I'll show you what it takes to take a Dynaco ST70 that looked like this and turn it into one that looks like this. We got a lot to cover, so let's get started. If you haven't already, please subscribe. Dynaco was a company that was founded in Philadelphia in the middle 50s, and the ST70 first came out in 1959. That's crazy for me to think about it. Something like this amplifier was available in 1959, and it was sold throughout the 1960s, and they produced 350,000 of these amplifiers. That's just an amazing number. I mean, I don't know if there's any other piece of audio equipment that's produced that number of units. I mean, 350,000. Boy, that's a bunch back in the 50s and throughout the 60s. My ST70 power amplifier was really in very rough shape, was not operational, and later on in the video, I'll show you the restoration of the ST70. The ST70 produces 35 watts per channel. The speaker outputs, there's three separate taps, 4-ohm, 8-ohm, and 16-ohm taps at the back of the unit, and it has a standard RCA inputs at the front of the unit. I obtained this ST70 in 2012 with a whole bunch of other pieces of equipment, and I don't have any figures on this, but the ST70, it must be the most modified piece of audio equipment ever. If you look out on the internet, just about every component has been changed by somebody. Just about every board has been changed. And there's even brand new ST70s out there. You know, remakes, updated ones, and then brand new ones that you can buy. So it has quite a history behind it. Dynaco also produced a kit version of this amplifier, and it was called a DynaKit. So sometimes you'll see DynaKits out there on the market for sale. So they sent you the kit, kind of old school, right? They sent you the chassis, sent you the parts, and gave you instructions, and you build it yourself at home. And then Dynaco ST70, which is what this one was a factory wired unit. The ST70 Dynaco, I received it just as you see it here. No tubes, obviously the original capacitors in it. Quite dirty, it'll clean up. So once I get past finding out why the power cord was cut, that was the first thing. When you see something like that on a piece of equipment, it doesn't give you a good feeling. And after taking the bottom cover off, it was quite dirty in there. Again, no surprise after this many years. And also, I found a lot of wires held together with electrical tape. So that wasn't good. Also, the ST70 has a reputation for the original artwork, the original boards that are in it being kind of weak, but they can be repaired. One good thing, there's not a whole lot to it. It's pretty easy to work on. This ST70 has its original power transformer as well as its original audio transformers. So I did a resistance test with my multimeter before powering the amp up, making sure I didn't have an issue there. The transformers checked out fine, and I installed a new power cord. As you remember, the power cord was cut, so I put a new power cord in there and about ready to fire up the ST70 for the first time. And once I got it up to the point I thought it could power it up, I installed some tubes in it and got it up and going. I used a variac to power it up slowly, just so I didn't get any surprises. I thought I could power it up, but it's always best to use a variac to make sure. Now I can clean the ST70 up a little bit. It's dirty. Most of that will end up coming off, and it did. This looks much better now. I'm able to, at this point, go ahead and install the tubes, got the new capacitors installed in it, and ready for it to make some music. I'll be using JJEL34 output tubes, along with new old stock Sylvania 7199 driver tubes, and I'll be using a JJ GZ34 rectifier tube. Well, we've gotten about 15-20 minutes of warm-up. Why do I do that? I don't know. Just seems like you should with tubes, right? Just let it warm up a little bit, let everything stabilize, and I think we're ready to rock and roll here.
There's something about my ST70 that I love. Can I put my finger on it? I'm not sure that I can, because I could pick this amplifier apart compared to some of my equipment that I listen to. I could complain about how its bass is not that authoritative, like a big solid state amp. I could complain about that. And maybe its upper registers are not quite as extended as some of my other equipment. But every time I listen to this amplifier, there's something about it. It just sounds great. It's hard to put your finger on it. The mid-range, first of all, the mid-range is outstanding. And it has this pleasant sound that whether I hook it up to solid state equipment or I hook it up to other vacuum tube equipment, it always sounds great. And I think to myself, this amplifier has been around 60 plus years. It's amazing. And the interesting thing is if you look through the history of audio equipment, there's many manufacturers that have copied this particular design. There's something to be said for the simplicity of the design. There's something to be said that so many of these amplifiers are still around, and you really don't have to be a genius to get them going. A lot of people complain about Dynaco boards. You know, they need to be modded to sound good. They're just not that good. This amplifier is good. I sit down and listen to this amplifier, and I'm always amazed at it. And I look at it, and I think, you know, I was born in 1958. It's about the same year this amplifier was born. Amazing. Amazing. The design and how it can still stand up in 2021 and sound good. I hope you enjoyed my Dynaco ST70 video, and if you did, please leave me a big thumbs up down below for you non-subscribers. If you like this video and you'd like to see more, please subscribe. And as always, thank you so much to my present subscribers. Y'all have a good day.